We're on the green sofa, as you can see, and we import these sofas from all over the world where we have special guests on. We have someone I can only describe as hip-hop royalty.
That's a good way of putting it, right?
Gifted Universal Rhymes Unlimited, a.k.a. Guru from Gangstar. When I'm so real to them, it's scary. And with my unique skills, nah, you can't compare me. Well, how you doing, Jude?
Man, I'm good. Just got a bit of jet lag, but it's all good. Back in London, haven't been here in almost 2 years, about, yeah.
You are 5 albums deep on Gangstar now. Let's talk about how you formed, because you came from Boston, which is not exactly New York, right?
Me and my mates back in Boston, we used to drive up to New York all the time, like on weekends, go to the clubs like Fever in the Bronx, and they had this club in Queens called the Encore, Black Quarters, you know, Union Square and all of that. Say that I'm God. You know, there was no breaks for the talent in Boston, and I was real frustrated, and so I just like saved up some money, packed my bags, and broke out. And I worked with 45 King, big up to him, for my my first couple of records, and Premier was getting into more jazz, and it was just really different, and he was doing it on 4-track. I stole his demo, actually, and was riding the train with it, rhyming over his rapper on the train and all that, just, you know, just vibing to it. And basically, the head of Wild Pitch decided to get us together on the telephone, and we started vibing, and we clicked right away, and then he decided to get us in the studio, and the rest is history. The first joint we did was Words I Manifest. Cause the words I manifest, they will take you, sedate you. And I will stress upon you the need for you all to feed your minds and souls so you can lead yourself. With Gangstar, we've always had more popularity, let's say, than sales, because there's no gimmick, so to speak. I mean, I don't call Premier up and say, yo, what you gonna wear on this photo shoot? And, you know, let's cut our hair the same way and all of that. So that's why it took us so long to come out since 94, because we decided we didn't want to come out without the right machine behind us.
Coming with the realness. Lyrics of life.
The Jazz Attached thing is, it opened a whole new door for you. You work with great artists such as Donald Byrd and Roy Ayers, and how pleasing was that to you? What was going through your mind then?
The Jazz Attached is like a demonstration of skills, of universality, taking the message to maybe a more mature, quote-unquote sophisticated crowd, also bringing the generations together.
Yo, I'm tired, Chump's trying to waste my time. I ain't got no time to play.
When Premier decided to do his outside ventures and producing some of the best rappers out there, I said, okay, I want to go and get the actual jazz cats who we do sample, and I want to do something experimental with them and get them to come and jam over hip-hop. The Gangstar, Premier can throw me a beat. Like there's a song Work on the album, and there's another one, the first single, You Know My Steez.
It's time to dethrone you clones and all you knuckleheads, cause MCs have used up extended warranties, while real MCs and DJs are a minority.
He gave me those beats and he said, these are gonna be hot depending on what you do to them.
Yeah.
You know? And You Know My Steez, I took into the studio without him around. He came back, my vocals were done, he was like, that's what I'm talking about. That's gonna be the first single.
One of the meanest and the cleanest, and still I'm kind of fiendish when I'm at this. Been doing this for eons, peons best to catch this.
Do you think it's one of your best albums today?
Definitely. I mean, it's on the level of Step in the Arena.
Guru, one of the nicest men in rap music. Time now for